lovely baubles.
Today we are going to play the game called Bilkins Folly, developed by Webisoft, published by Armor Game Studios, and released a couple of days ago, actually. On Steam, they're having the text, Percy's on a quest to find his missing relatives, and he needs your help. Join him and his beloved dog, Drayton, as they adventure through a series of unusual islands, solve puzzles to uncover valuable treasure, and bring to light the foreboding family secret buried beneath it all. Tags are single player, adventure, and puzzle. And we're about to start, actually. Let's do it. New game. Choose your difficulty level. This can be changed later on if needed. So there's normal and hard, but I think I'm gonna stick to normal. A balanced mix of puzzle and hints, recommended for most players. Oh, you're also getting hints, okay. And hard. A tougher experience includes unskippable puzzles, fewer hints, and cryptic NPCs. This is for the puzzle veterans, I guess. But we're gonna stick to normal, and we're about to start. Let's go.
In the world of the treasure hunter, what is the greatest prize of all? Is it gold and precious gems? Or the call of adventure? Could it be our family ties? Our link through the ages? Or is it something else entirely? We join Percy Bilkins as he sails into the new world, searching for his lost mother and grandfather. But while those
no, the dog is so cute. And I was calling
Percy,
a dog today, actually.
The voyage of destiny rarely tracks a course knowingly charted.
So where is my dog? Good morning. I also tried to start the game with a controller. You can't play with a controller. What? Wow. That storm? What? What is this language? Lucky to be to your life? Where am I? Wait, what? I think it's a fantasy language. Ahoy there, treasure hunter, and welcome to the Caribbean. To help you get you started, remember these. It's like The Sims. I was thinking, what is this language? But no, it's gibberish. I have no idea what this is. It's Simlish, yes. I was thinking, do you know this language? No, I couldn't figure it out. So, fantasy language. Let's see. WSD is movement. Internet E is interact with nearby objects. We're having a journal, luckily. There is an area map, and you can also call the tutorial again. All right. Look for a survivor is a washed up. It's a washed up a watch player. After sailing all the way from Ireland in a leaky old yacht, I've run aground or around on the last leg of the journey. Without my equipment and boat, I might be stuck on this island for a while. The only problem is, I don't know where I am. I better do some scouting and see if I can get back on track. If I've got any hope of finding my mom and pop. So this is the main quest. Also gonna be side quest. My mouse feels a bit off here. There is like a little delay. And completed, well, we didn't complete anything. And then there is this map, I guess? I was thinking, is this a calendar? No, these are the coordinates, I think. This is the map. Stonehenge, a lonely palm, Quest log, treasure hunting gear, and interesting items. Beautiful booty. Booty. A booty. Terrific toys for Drayton and fantastic fish. Jingling junk. I just figured out these are all alliterations. Look at those interesting items. Beautiful. Yes, also beautiful booty, probably. All right, let's look for survivors. I love this world. I love how it's looking like. Welcome to Lonely Palm Island. The sun is the property of Jake Grubbs Island Tours. Huh. Why do you know this quote, Pan? Why do you know it's number one? We need definitely more quotes, so you guys are forgetting the numbers. I wonder what strange and mystical civilization placed the status here. It's kind of putting me off because I was thinking there was voice acting.
It did.
The Dutch? Was it you? Okay. There is no interaction here. It's looking like I could harvest those plants, but it's just decoration. What are you looking at, mate? Okay. A large statue. There is also a chest here. Weird. I will neither deny nor confirm it was me. It wasn't me. It's the chest with some of my mapping equipment. We probably need this one. But for now, I lost the key though and don't have any way of opening this right now. I'll have to remember to come back later to collect it. Question. As you travel the world, you are bound to run into obstacles where a solution is not immediately obvious, such as the one you've just bumped into. Whether it's a locked chest, a curious rock marking, or a seemingly blocked path, you're bound to meet someone with a hint, discover a critical clue somewhere, or gain an item that will help you solve the issue. Just remember, if a particular puzzle seems unsolvable, you can always come back later with better tools and knowledge to crack that nut. That's good. I was actually looking for a setting here. Options, voice volume. I hope there's not going to be another cutscene because I'm going to maybe put it down on 20% because it's actually putting me off. So I will just do that. I'm not quite sure how it's going to be in a cutscene now. Can we walk down here? Oh! Hi there! Oh! What are you doing sneaking up on people like that? I nearly jumped out of my skin. That's a pirate ghost. Blimey, tourists. So then, what brings you to Lonely Palm Island? Curious, though. My ship wrecked. Almost drowned. Are you feeling okay? I feel fantastic. Why? You're undead. I'm not quite sure if the ghost knows that it's undead. You look a little pale. There's a sword sticking out of you. You're a ghoul. What's the difference between a ghoul and a ghost? I have no idea. For some reason, I remember some of the quotes really well. I don't know if that's a good thing or not. No, you get a... You're remembering a lot of things then. That's good. Quite useful, actually. Anyway, I'm taking some notes from my cat and go to sleep. You should do that. Dear Georgia, thank you so much for tuning in. Have a good night, sleep well, and have a good start to the new week. Oh, there's a sword sticking out of you. I hope he knows that. You have cutlass in your bag. You do know you're a ghost, right? What? A ghost? Are you sure? Oh, I'm sure. Oh, man! You're dead, my dude. Well, I guess that would explain a few things. Like my urge to destroy the living. Okay. Excuse me? Relax. I'm only joking. Say, what's the name, kid? Percival Bilkins. Treasure hunter extraordinaire. My friends call me Percy. A treasure hunter. We don't see many of them around here. Well, I stranded here. You sure you're not some mighty pirate? What? No. I'm no pirate. I'm a treasure hunter. In fact, I come from a long line of treasure hunters. Well, Percy, my name's Cedric. Pleased to meet you. Who are you? What's your story about this island? So who are you? What happened to this ghost ghoul? Ghouls are more like zombies, I would say. Oh, yeah. A ghoul is sentient zombie. Interesting. But it's looking like a ghost to me. Well, it's a ghoul, I guess. Hi, dear Jan. Good evening to you. Welcome to the stream. How's it going? Who are you? What's your name? Oh yeah, Cedric Eichenhauer, the resident ghost of Lonely Palm Island, I guess. So it's not a ghoul anymore. And about this island? Any clue where we are? Lonely Palm Island. Do you have a nautical map in that journal? As a matter of fact, I do, but I don't have access yet. If you look at it, you'll see we're just north of Crab Island. And what's with all the stone heads around here? Ah, yep. What are they for? No idea. Have you got a map of the island in that journal of yours? I sure do. I've been marking their positions on it too. We didn't, but maybe we should. I need to get out of here. How can I do that? The music is nice. Already, he just got here. Why not stay a while? Make yourself comfortable. Enjoy the sunshine. Have a coconut on me. No, thanks. I'm here for treasure hunting. Anything interesting to here? Oh, there's the palm tree down on the west beach. That's always worth visiting if you haven't done so already. There's a strange rock southeast of here. Southeast on the right side then. Oh, the stoneheads, of course. Yep, it's fun. Fun here. Maybe you died of boredom. Hey! We should maybe talk about the treasure hunting. I'm doing good. How about you, Mimi? Freezing. It's super cold here. Very, very cold. I'm sitting here with my blanket and my hands are peeking out. I'm actually looking like a dementor, I think. I've been looking a little the last stream. That's completely fine. Thank you for the lurk. I always appreciate that. Anything valuable around here? Like buried treasure? Yes! Maybe. I'm sure if there is a treasure hunter like you, will be able to find it. Then we got everything right. Let me ask you something else. What's your story? I can't say I remember it too much. After dreadful storm, I washed up here on Lonely Palm Island, just like me. It wasn't all bad, though. I had my best friend, Charles Blum, to keep me company. What happened to him? I recall us discussing ways to get off the island. Huh. Charles wanted to swim down to Crab Island while I thought we could make a boat from that palm tree near the beach. But something went wrong. Swimming sounds like a bad idea. Oh, I missed a message. Still, Blum was insisted that the tree wouldn't float. That we just needed a good source of protein to get our spirits up for the journey. Oh no. You can just eat those cute little crabs? Well, no. Charles had a shellfish allergy. Oh, that's really bad then. It would make him all itchy and irritable. Huh. Meanwhile, I'm on a strict meat-free, gluten-free, taste-free diet due to lifestyle choice. That sounds like a very hard life. I think I've heard enough. So, what should I do next then? Advice? Oh, is this help then? You could start by exploring the rest of the island. I think so. Well, alright. Maybe this is what it's standing for. The symbol. Can I do anything to help about that sword in your back? But this is also... Oh, that's a quest, I guess. It's because I think that's a cue here. Can I do anything to help then? Since you asked, this aching back is killing me. Maybe I can pull it. Love to be able to lie my back again. About that sword in your back then. That sword, I want it. And I want you to have it. It's a win-win situation. If you find my body, it's all yours. Oh, I need to find the body first. How did I get in your back anyway? beats me. One moment Charles was inviting me over to look at the beautiful sunset over Crab Island. Then the next thing I know, I'm traversing the underworld. Charles killed him? Is the body even still existing there? Don't you think Charles had anything to do with my death? Huh. About your head. So he's a pirate, right? Nice hat. Thanks. Where are the rest of your clothes? Two who's only having his hat on. That's a bit personal, isn't it? Sheesh. Sorry. Where are your legs? I don't know. Where are your legs? Well, I'm having them right here on my hips. Show off. All right, see ya. I gotta go. Bye-bye. All right, look for survivors. We are looking around. Wait, I can hear a dog. Is that my dog? It's coming from somewhere. Another one. So how does it work? My map. Oh, they are marked on the map Stonehead. And there are also arrows here. Down, up, right, up, down, and to the left. Oh, interesting. But right now, I don't know what it means. Let's see. Can I go here? Can I walk here on the water? Can I swim? I can't. So maybe we should stick to the island. I think this one is staring at Crab Island. Huh. Maybe he wants to get out of here too. You can keep your hat on. Yeah, I was thinking about the same song. Doggy? Doggy's fighting with a crab. Oh, the nose! Oh, look at the animation. It's so well made. Oi! How sweet is this? So well animated. No, we're not alone. And there is a journal here. This is Drayton. Oh, Drayton is so cute. It's nice not to be alone on this island. You've unlocked your first crew member. Drayton was your mother's dog, left behind in your care when she sailed off in search of your grandfather. With no one else to care for him, Percy decided to bring Drayton along the trip across the Atlantic. He's now a veritable sea dog. All right. And we have got this book here. Day one. Bah, what poor luck. Stranded on this miserable island with that fool Cedric. Never the worry. Crab Island's not far south of here. I'm sure a rescue will pass in no time and I'll be back on my secret mission. So this is Charles' journal, I guess. Day number 6. Rots me luck. No rescue I'll be coming, I fear. Cedric's been on me nerves the last few days. No luck with them stoneheads that be laying about. Day number 9. Curses, I'm so hungry. Oh my god. Day 10. A terrible accident. Cedric tripped and fell on the sword that I'd carelessly left laying about. Alas, poor Cedric, cut down in the prime of his life. So this is how it happened. It was an accident. Oh, it was an accident, sure. Drayton is the new Wilson a bit, right? It's always nice to have a companion in a game. You're never feeling that alone. I think that might be also the reason why you are getting some kind of companion. Maybe it's some kind of psychological trick. I feel always a bit more comfortable when I'm having someone around. At least in game. Aren't crab pincers really strong if they decide to pinch you? I wonder how painful it would be on dogs. I have no idea. I have no idea. But I don't want to try it out. No, I don't want to try it out. But I think it hurts a lot. I think it's actually hurting a lot. I mean, if you're giving them a nut, they would probably crack that. But also, I mean, look at some birds. They're also having their beaks. They're super, super strong. They can also just easily crack some walnuts, for example. That's not a problem at all. Well, I can't do this with my bare hands. Yeah, impossible. Impossible. I could step on it, yeah, but then I would also destroy it. I have no idea how strong they are, actually. No idea. But it's always looking very strong. Day number 11, I've decided to give Cedric a proper burial. I'll make use of those funny stone heads laying about to mark his whereabouts. So we are going to find his stuff. Broke my favorite shell while burying Cedric. I was so angry, I threw the head in a rage. Heard it bouncing off some rocks before a big splash. When looked for, I couldn't find the bloody thing. Left the rest of the shell at those weird block things kind of near the rock with the funny markings. And day number 12, with my strength recovered, I've decided to try this to swim over to Crab Island. And there is probably another page. Here's hoping I can dog paddle that far. Au revoir, city, me old buddy. So all right, this journal was very important to get this information here. We need to find Cedric's belongings. It's very important, I guess. And for this, we need to follow those rocks. Heard bouncing of some rocks. No, that was the head. I'll make use of those funny stone heads laying about to mark his whereabouts. Alrighty. Something just fell out of this diary, though. What is it? As any treasure hunter knows, maps and clues are essential for track down the best booty. Pressing C in-game will bring up any maps for the active quest. You can switch active quest in the journal. Okay. So what is this, though? So the first thing... Okay, it's starting with the second part on the left side, but the first part is on the right side. And I think that's the island. That's the island, and there is a cross. There is a marking inside the water. I didn't even discover everything on this island, I think. And I have no idea what the second part is. Probably something between the rocks. But what's this on the left side, then? What's this long part? Or maybe it's also the island and there are buildings and it's in between. Or those are some kind of mountains. I don't think so. They are very steep. Some parrots can even bite off finger. You need to be very, very careful. Super dangerous. Looks like Cedric's friend had a shovel in his possessions during his island holiday. Mm-hmm. If I find it, I'll be able to dig up lots of interesting things. Alright, find the shovel. So let's look around what these islands are. I wanna... Oh? Doggy? Wait, what? What you got there, boy? Maybe I should dig this up, but I don't have a shovel. It looks like Drayton has picked up the scent of something in the ground. Why not dig it up? The deeper Percy digs, the wider the dig radius becomes, giving a higher chance of finding something. As Percy and Drayton continue their adventure, they will find better tools that will let them dig faster and break through harder ground. Keep your eyes open if start digging. Is that possible even without? Oh, of course, with our bare hands. So exciting, what is it? I found something. It's a bottle? Message in a bottle? Find your first piece of junk. Just a junky old bottle, completely worthless. But was good for, as an example. Okay, you're a good boy for finding it, of course. So if you want to sniff out something more worthwhile, then that would be great. Poor Drayton. Yeah, I guess you're right. That would make my life too easy. The junk trail. I also get a new quest. I think it's a side quest then. Yes. After sailing all the way... Wait, is this the same message? No, right? No, it is. After sailing all the way from island in a leaky-old yacht, I've gone... Mm-hmm. Met a friendly ghost on the island. Oh, this is a summary of everything. The junk trail. Of course, that means his real buddy must have a real sword sticking out of it too. Don't ask me how I know these things, okay? If I can find his corpse, I should be able to pull the blade out and keep it myself. Plus, Cedric will appreciate being laid to rest properly. Everyone wins. Things are looking up. After scouting around the island, I found Drayton annoying the local wildlife. And Mom left Drayton in my care when she took off after my grandfather. I've been looking after him ever since. It's nice to be reunited. Good boy. But it's not giving me... Is this... Oh, there you go. You need to... I was clicking here, but you need to click over here. There's junk bird all over these islands that Drayton is able to sniff out. Maybe I'll meet someone who's interested in the pieces I find. Okay. But we don't need to make this active, though. All right. Hi, Sinister. Hello, hello. Welcome to the stream. Good day to you. Had a crab steal a knife from my hand, throw it at me. No. I know. I also saw those vids. Can I interact with the birds? No, they're just flying away. Oh, sniffing again. Do you find something? I'll help you. All the excitement. Assassin's crap. Heaven infused cork. Smells just like rum. Fits to this island, huh? Do, 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 do. So, we also got an inventory. How can I open this again? Over here, treasure hunting gear. No, it should be over here. Interesting items or this one. Jingling junk. Messageless bottle. There is not even a message inside. And rummy cork. Okay. All right. Let's see. It's another one of those weird statue heads. It's looking across at the other half of the island. So are we done with the island? Oh, I'm coming. Where's Doggo? I don't know where you were still here. Maybe it's another one. Here? Link web a bit, right? With lots of puzzles, though. Nothing. Nothing. Why you... That was a false alarm, I guess. All right. I just moved away. Maybe it's scared of being alone. Why are you calling me? Can I interact with you? Okay, I'm gonna do it again. Maybe the radio was not good enough. Or maybe just doing it for fun. Hi, dear Jared. Welcome to the stream. No, we're not eating sand, but we're trying to find some treasure. Toss me more sand, lots of sand. Alright, I think we are actually done with this island. So, this is the whole island here. And I think this is what we saw, actually. This is one of the buildings. Or the ruins. What's that? My first junk. Blum's camp. Strange rock. Did we see the strange rock? And the stone hat. Can even walk here? No? Yep, I think that's the whole island. Find the shovel. But I don't think I went down. This is where we started. I need some kind of a key so I can open it up. Oh, that was this rock here. Oh, what the hell is this? Okay, oh. Numberly rocks. Doggo. Maybe some new trash. Who are you? Where's Doggo? Okay, can't even find Dogger. And I bet once I'm staying there again, it's gonna bark. Da 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 da. Oh! There's a large island over there. That's the Crab Island, right? Wish I could swim. And this is why you should learn the swimming. Sim, I think your dog needs to go out in the... That's my big garden here. It's a very big one. But I lost my dog. I can't even find my dog anymore. Where is it? On the right side? I bet it's still standing on the right side and it's just barking every now and then. Right? Are you still staying there? No. It moved. Where are you? Over here! Here? Okay, I'll do it. Let's do it together. I found something. What is it? A rusty ship name. That sounds like junk. I bet it came from a Spanish treasure galleon. Ta-da! Yeah, it's looking very rusty and a huge nail. Definitely junk. Alright. We have this map here now. So, it's divided in two parts, this island. So I assume this is the gap we are seeing on the map, right? So where am I standing? Maybe on the left side. Yeah, on the left side. I think I went a bit too far. Da, 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 da. Also here maybe, in between. I can see there's something. What is this? A shovel head. This must be the one that Blum threw away when he was angry. Silly. But we need the rest. Right? If I had a handle, I could use this to dig up the island. We need the handle. Maybe this is where I need to get the second part. So what does that mean, the second part? Something in between. A handle. In between on the map? Maybe two rocks? But I think one of the rock... Huh. Or maybe it's the shape of these rocks here. Need to get out the water. Oh no, it's here! It's here! It's right in front of me! That's the handle, right? Wait, it must be here somewhere. In between. Huh. I found something. Is it the handle? It wouldn't stick! Nice! So it works like that. Oh, this is so satisfying. This is Blum's shovel handle. Now I can dig up the rest of this dinky island. Rusty shovel is done. Oh, it's looking very rusty, actually. But better than nothing. All right. There's something else in this hole. Huh. It looks like a map of some sort. I bet Blum I dropped it in here by mistake. What you got there? I think it has something to do with the tombstone, right? It's saying RIP. And I have no idea what the other item is. Maybe some kind of a statue we need to move? We need to move it up. And the second one right at this corner, there is a marking. But I bet it makes more sense once we are finding that place, right? Spoiler, X marks the spot, I guess so. It looks like a hat you're moving. It's looking very grumpy, the right one. Yeah, I think so. The next quest would be find Cedric's grave. Let's see. Side quest should be done, right? No. Oh, wait. We found the Snumberly rocks here. Before I'm reading this, it was right here, right? So, what is this about? You are having lots of numbers. So, we've got 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Everything is here. Also, I've got this diamond symbol and the arrow buttons here as well. Goes up, left, right, and down. So it's pretty much containing everything. Doggy, I'm coming. You found something. What is it? Where are you? Grumpy Easter Island hat. Yeah, pretty much. It's looking like this one. Wait, can I move those? Like this one. Doggy. Unfortunately, I can't walk down here, so I always have to go around. This is also looking kind of sus with the rocks around, right? I'm just gonna try my luck. Wait, yes? A wooden nickel? I'm rich? I don't think so. Ta-da! It was looking a bit sus with the rocks around, but I'll take it. Plop. Rich. $1. Very, very rich. Hi there. You were calling me here, right? I don't think we're gonna find something. No, nothing. Nope. But there was something with about the Numberly rocks. I discovered a peculiar tablet with strange markings on it. Without the proper equipment, it was impossible to decipher what the markings might mean. Maybe if I find someone who specializes in this unusual, they can help me solve the mystery of this rock. Who knows? Maybe it will lead to a fabulous treasure. Maybe. I don't want to make them active because we need to find the people first. So we're gonna still focus on the buddy, or the grave, I should say. I discovered peculiar tablet. No, washed up. This one. If I found a wooden shovel in the handle, if I can find the rest of it, I might be able to dig up the grass on this little island, which we're gonna do. I need to do something with those rocks, I think. I think it has something to do with the directions these rocks are looking. Like this one, up, and right one. The point where they're crossing, I probably need to dig up there, right? Alright, let me see. Where are these, the rocks here? One is up and left. Up is here. Also up is here. But left is here. Stonehead. But they're never gonna cross then. Same with here, up and left. So I think that, what are you looking at, mate? Gotta go already since hyper early wake up. Good night, everyone, and have a great start to the new week. You too, Pan, you too, have a good start to the new week and sleep well. Good luck tomorrow with your appointment. You got this. So I found Grumpy here, but I can't move it though. No, nothing. I just wanted to test it out. Nope. A Also, I'm a bit confused about the background here. Is this just decoration or the whole map? It's not the shape of my map, though. I think that's just decoration. Crossing. They will never cross here. There is an X. To the left and up. Wait a second, they're crossing here though. Maybe it's here? Huh. And where am I? I'm very close, right? Yeah, maybe it's gonna cross over there. I'm gonna try my luck. Oopsie. Also, gotta head to bed as well. Good night, everyone. Wishing you all the best. You too. You too, Yuyan. Sleep well and tired. Thanks for being here. Thanks for tuning in. Maybe I need to go a bit down like this. Well, this is looking good. It should be here, but I don't have a good feeling. No, it should be already here, right? Doing. There is nothing here. All right, I wanted to give it a try. Tips to successful treasure hunt. See any clues to the active quest. View the journal. Check out the local map. It's super useful. Observe the environment for anything out of the ordinary. Ask the locals for help. Okay. I'm good for now. I'm still trying to figure out. Yeah, I think the local map is going to be super useful. And I still think it has something to do with the crossing. But why is this here then? Probably just showing, okay, this is going into this direction and the arrow which is showing down is going down here. Ah, Madame Streamer! How are you going to play Song of Nuna, a League of Legends? That was the game which was showcased, right? And I couldn't find it over Steam. Was it the super cute game? If so, I'm super, super interested because it was looking awesome. Welcome back, Des. So is this map telling me something? Maybe here? No, this is where Cedric is, basically. Let me ask. Oh, I can also be super fast. Whee! I'm gonna ask Cedric here. What was in the hole? We actually need to talk to him anyway. A map? I think it shows where he buried. Good one, classic Plum. Okay. What should I do next then? Any hints? Now that you have a shell, you could find my grave. Yeah, that's what we're trying. And? Well, you know, now that you've pointed out, I think I'd like this cutlass taken out of my bag. I know, I want to help you. You said you want to lie down again. I think it's the cute game. Yeah, then I'm super, super interested in. I'm getting super warm though. Give me a second. I'm going to take off my sweater. All right. Oh, so much better. It's not cold anymore. All right. See ya then. See ya. I gotta go. It's the boy with a blue big dog. Oh, I can't remember this one. It's a long time ago. So, Chad, do you have an idea what this means? I really thought this is exactly where they're gonna meet those lines. One is going up and one is going to the left side. And this is just, in another illustration, which direction it chose. And I really thought they were going to meet... Oh, oopsie. This is not what I wanted to do. So I thought it might be here. To the left side. Then we're also having this one to the left side, but they're never gonna hit here. I feel like you have to push some stuff around, judging by the picture. But I couldn't push those rocks. I also thought about that. It's a stage here. I can't push them. I can't push them. Find Cedric's grave. Now, I'm pretty sure it also has something to do with digging. I think this whole game is about digging a lot of stuff here. Can you dig them? You mean those statues? Only in front of it, but I think that's not the point. No, I think... Wait a second, I didn't check out though. Is the map even showing me the right one? Look at this, the arrow is looking down here. And what's about the map? Ah, it's also showing down here. Da, 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 da. Up and left side. Okay, we can ignore this part though. And it's really not this one? That's what we call Schnittstelle in German. It's exactly where these two lines are cutting, meeting each other. Up and left side. But I already did it here. I'm just gonna do it here again. Maybe it was not the right... Yeah. I think I went a bit too much down. I wanted to... Wait, I found something different. Gross. I thought it's the body. I think we found the body. There was a little piece of the body over there. This is pretty blunt. Crusty. Yeah, I went the right way. But I had to go a bit more up. Crusty cutlass. Well... That's why our characters are gross. You know, there really are quite a few bones down here. Yeah? What's up? I betcha would. Give Drayton a bone, put Cedric to rest. Oh no! I can't give a human bone. No, Drayton, we can't do that. Sorry, boy, but no munching on human based treats for you. No, I'm sorry. Cedric should rest now. Forever, hopefully. Wow, I'm so sorry, but this is so wrong. We want to help Cedric. On the other side, I don't think Cedric would mind. See ya, Cedric. Rest in peace. Escape Lonely Palm Island. We did it. So, what's next? I found a... No, never mind. I discovered Cedric's grave. Between the worms, I glimpsed an old sword buried in his back and borrowed it. Hopefully it's sharp enough to cut down the palm tree on the south side of the island. Let's do it then. You've been a good boy. I know. We're going to find something different. Something else. Your coconuts or your life. This shouldn't take long. Chop. Weeks later. A few moments later. It shouldn't take that long. I name you P.S. Stumpy. I hope there aren't any sharks out there. Come on, Drayton. So this is the huge island. Oh, look at this, by the way. Gumford CE, map 17B. Wow, it's so big. Oh, you can already see the islands here, I guess. I really like this music. I'm not sure how I feel about using a sword to chop a tree. Better than nothing, right? Better than nothing. All right, it's travel time. Travel to Crab Island. It seems like there is also, probably not a volcano, but some kind of a mountain. Different kind of mountains. Well, let's travel there. Crab Island. Wait, does this actually work? Uh-oh. No, we're not going to chill anymore. Faster. There are sharks. There's a lighthouse as well, yeah. The Hunter and the Hound. Act number one. Seems like a very decent game so far. Reach Crab Island. Oh, there's someone here. Ahoy there, sailor. The name's Jake Grubb. What brings you to Crab Island? Percy Bilkins, the name. Treasure hunting adventurer. Another treasure hunter? You'd think there'd be no treasure left in those isles with the way you lot get around. Are we welcome, though? Say, that palm tree you rode in on, it looks familiar. That's Lonely Palm. Oh, that, I used to escape Lonely Palm Island. What? You destroyed a priceless national icon. Oh, oops. I'm sorry. Really? There was a sign on the island. Why didn't you use that as a kickboard to swim across? Yeah, why didn't we do this, Chad? hi, Suzik. Welcome to the stream. Now that will attract the tourists. What will attract the tourists? The economy will tank. I feel bad. An ecological disaster. That was the last tree. It's not a Lonely Palm Island anymore. It's no Palm Island anymore. Great. Well, he's going to be more grumpy now. Good job. Thanks a lot. Sorry? Well, guess I'll need to get over there and change the sign. I think that was a bit of sarcasm. Ask about the boat. Ask about Crab Island searching for family. I'm not quite sure if he... I think he's going to be very grumpy now. Was this an option to take the sign? I don't think so. But the game's name is Bikini's Folly. I did the same mistake. It's Bilkins Folly, though. I did the same mistake. Hi, Susie. Welcome to the stream. How's it going? We just got to build a giant neon sign. Yeah. What about the electricity? Of course, with solar panels, right? Ask about the boat. You have a boat? That's a problem. Only person on this island with a boat is Russell, and he's not moving anytime soon. Maybe we can motivate him? What do you ask? I lost my ship out at sea and need a replacement. I'm on a quest. A quest, huh? Well, Russell's boat is more of a dinghy. Won't be much good on an adventure. I did hear that an old salt had parked his ship over in Palmy Island. I guess you could go talk to him. Maybe he will part ways with it. Might be a perilous journey on that floating lock of yours, though. Floating lock. Oh, I'm not taking Stumpy out again. She's retired. A shame. You actually wasted a tree. Cut down in the prime of her life, too. You want off this island? You better go talk to Russell. We should talk about the Crab Island, I guess. Maybe he knows about Charles. Is he still here? Get a giant hamster wheel for the dog. that could work. Getting electricity like that, huh? Something, something, newbie's old PC hamster. You're right about that. About Crab Island. When can you tell me about this place? Crab Island? Should have named it Crab Island, if you ask me. There's not much in the way of prospect here. Plenty of down salts and crew who prefer to stay lost. If I was starting my adventure here, I'd be looking to leave as soon as possible. It's an island. What's the best way to leave then? That's the rub. Look at all the wrecks. Plenty of ships have come in over the years, but not many have left. If it's a wreck you want, then you came to the right place. Only fellow with anything remotely seaworthy is Russell. Good luck talking to him. How many people are living here? Searching for family. I'm looking for some people. Winston, Bilkins, and his daughter Rosemary. I look kind of like them. Yeah, now that you mention it, I thought you looked familiar for some reason. I've seen them. Both of them, that is, but at separate times. Huh. We've been years apart, too. Something about a fabulous treasure he was hunting got lost up in the way, though. She was hunting him. Oh, that's my mom. Well, neither of them are on Crab Island anymore. So we missed them. I might have written about him in one of my journals, though. If you got the interest. Oh, I've interest? I thought so. I've been in my shack seeing what I can dig up about your family being on Crab Island. Huh, I wonder what he was writing down there. Just a way south of here. Come visit when you get a chance. Will do. But first of all, we should look around. Oh, and Percy? I forgive you. I better get my hands on those diaries. I'm glad he's forgiving me. To Jake's shack. Speak to Jake in his shack. All right. The great familiar crab hunt. After using Cedric's sword to cut down Lonely Palm, Drayton and I escaped the crab island. As we came ashore, we were greeted by one Jake Grubb. After grumbling about the damage we caused in escaping our deserted island, he mentioned a couple of important tidbits. Apparently, there's a retired captain hanging out around Thelmy Island with his ship. It's a lost mine in the storm. I should head over there and see if he's willing to pay ways with it. I'm not going back out on Stumpy, though. I'll need a new way to get over the Pelmy or Thelmy Island. Thelmy, probably. Jake mentioned a guy in the town called Russell who will be able to help. He did say that he's not in a great state. What does that even mean? Guess I'll find out when I meet this Russell fellow. And then, most importantly though, Jake revealed that he had met both my mother Rosemary and grandfather Winston when they were on Crab Island, and that he may have written about them in his diaries. I should visit him at his shack and inquire further. Wanted to stop by and say hello before heading to bed. Might I ask when the next Assassin's Creed video is coming out? I try to play it maybe next Sunday again. So most likely I'm going to stream it next Sunday again, but I need to go home first. I'm going to travel on Wednesday. So there's not going to be a stream on Wednesday, but I planned some other games in between. So most likely I might going to play it actually on Thursday on stream again. I would love to play more. I also saw it's actually not that big, like playtime-wise, so actually doable while streaming. Hi, the Coop. Welcome to the stream. Thanks for tuning in. I really appreciate it. Hi there. I wonder if we are also able to go back to the other island again. Probably at some point. Sounds good. Looking forward to it. Me too. I'm very, very happy about... playing this game again, because I really, really want to. All right. So this is this huge map. These are graves here. Okay. I guess. Oh, wait, you're sniffing something. Did you find something? Okay, we'll do it. Let's do it. Oi?
squillage in there?
A conquistador's helmet. Wow. It has a pretty hefty dent in it too. That sounds very important. Oh! That's not gonna be junk, right? I don't think so. Let me actually check this out. Over here. No, it was here at treasure. So these are interesting items. Wood nickels. Don't tell me it's here. Bruce Spanish helmet. Damn, it's actually in this category. Okay. All right. Play some Diablo. Wait a second. Who's this? Why is he green? Are you friendly? What the hell is happening here? No stream on Wednesday, but how will we entertain ourselves? I will. I think at 9 p.m. in the evening, there will be something published over YouTube. So I'm never leaving you guys alone. If you want to hear a familiar voice. It's cute though. More Who's this? Hi. Hi there. My name's Carlos. I'm Percy. Say, are you okay? Never better. I know what you're thinking, but being dead is so much better than being alive. I'd thoroughly recommend it. Okay. Well, I'm glad. Say, Percy, are you a fan of music? I've been known to hum a line or two. I know a song about the spot. Did you want to hear it? Sure. Why not? Perfect time for hi-fi rush stream. That's never gonna happen on super hard mode. Mm-hmm. I think he didn't even finish Metal Hellsinger. I loved that game, by the way. It was so, so good. Yes, I want to hear the song. To the grub's domain, atop a settled nest, X marks the spot. Between the southern tower and Blum's place of rest, X marks the spot. X marks the spot. X marks the spot. I wonder, just because I turned down the voice. Is that the reason why we can't hear somebody singing? Carlos corpse, the crap, something. Actually, let me check this out again. Voice volume, let's put it back to 90%. Let me see. Do you want to hear it? Yes, I want to hear it again. No, between the grub's domain, atop a settled nest, eggs marks the spot. Between the southern tower and Blum's place of rest, X marks the spot. Okay. Da-da-da-da-da. X marks the spot. All right, it's probably also here in our side quest, right? This one. On Crab Island, I met a singing zombie named Carlos. If I listen carefully to this song, I might be able to discern some secret of the island. Between the grub's domain, atop a settled nest. Okay, between the southern tower, a Blum's place of rest. So Blum is also dead, I guess. Pop music, I love tavern music a lot. I love that so, so much. It's super authentic. So Grub's domain is pretty much his home. That's just a synonym, right? Atop a settled nest. Okay. All right. But I wanted to explore the whole island first. Grace has sent Haven. Joel, Seth sent Haven as well. Is that the whole family here? And Miles sent Haven. Na na da da. Oh, we can't go. Never mind. Was that just decoration? Oh, I'm curious though. Can we find something here in the right in the middle? Aha! There's something here.
Danny.
An old ring.
Thank you, Prisca.
Stay to my booty collection. Wink. All right, $2. Now we get $3. Damn, we're getting slowly rich. Da, da, da. No interaction here. Sniffing? You got something? Yes, I will help you. Dum, dum, dum.
Byron, will I know?
It's a cannonball. I bet I got stopped during a chaotic battle. Pretty heavy even. Huh. Ta-da. Could be also black material. Yep, casually finding it over here. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Oh, there's a sign here. The Grub Shack. Stay away, fools. Speak to Jake. Somebody's inside, I think. Oh, yeah. Ahoy there, Percy. Welcome to the Grub Shack. Ask about Jake's diaries. Did you find out anything about my family? I thought I might have something written about them in one of my old diaries, but it seems like I've misplaced them. Of course. And I need to dig them out. You what now? Oh, I think I moved them during the great cleanup of 78. I recall burying them, but... Well... I can't remember where. Are you kidding? No, I'm not. Not to fret, though. I draw maps and notes for all my buried goodies. You take this note and see if you can find where I stashed them. Huh. Come back when you do. Thanks. Uh-huh. Hesitating it. There's a bunch of numbers on this page. Yep, it's an old pirate's trusted measuring tool. It's the foot. You'll have to count how many steps you've taken. No, I'm so bad with that. How can you do this in-game? Lost amidst the forest. Oh, wait a second. It looks like Jake's used the trusty old pirate's stride to hide his precious diaries. Oh, no. Not to worry, though. Percy can count it to at least double digits when he's walking. Just hold down space while moving. Percy will start counting up steps. Ah, okay. I need to hold space. Okay, interesting. Okay, lost amidst the forest. IB. Nine brave steps to West Stifley. By such turn... 4 north did treat, then 12 by east. I made my bed. Tread. Oh no, not treat, it's tread. So, lost amidst the forest I be, 9 brave steps to the west I flee. By such turn, 4 north did tread, then 12 by east I made my bed. So, 9 to the left side. North, 4 steps to the north. Up. And then 12 to the right side. But I need to find the forest first. Should be doable. Right? All right. That should be doable. There was also another conversation here. Any luck with the old diaries? Nope. I didn't try yet. About Jake. What's your story? Well, I've been on this island nearly as long as Barnabas and his crew. Came over here to get away from the English in Leaky Harbor. Wait, were you in trouble? You could say that. I got into it with the governor's mistress and found myself on the run. What? I needed a place to lie down for a time and stumbled on Crab Island. Guess I must have liked it here as I've stayed ever since. The governor's mistress? Yeah, I was a real love spot back in the day. Back in the day. Kind of fitting with the music. A bit nostalgic here, uh-huh. There is a chest here. But I think that's just decoration. Anything here, maybe? More crabs, a boat. I think that's just decoration. And was there a forest here? There's no forest here yet. See, maybe we're gonna discover more sus things along the beach. Is that the forest we're talking about? It's very dense. That's a skeleton. Looks like something was nibbling at him. Craps. Everything. I think this was Cedric's friend? I guess swimming wasn't such a great idea after all. Damn. She've gotten a lock? Well, it's too late now. There's some sort of weird device here. What is it? It looks like Blum wasn't the swimmer he thought he was. Among his remains, Percy found this strange device. With a bit of luck, he might be able to solve the code and discover why Blum was trying to get to Crab Island. A and D move device left and right. W and D shift letters and column. Oh, okay. Oh, wow, that's going to be very hard because English is not my native language, but we're going to try to do that. So, okay, sets dead vowel. Okay. So we need to write something down. Maybe I should start. And what does this mean here? There are these symbols. Oh, I have no idea. Maybe we should do this later on. It doesn't make sense what I'm writing here. Fuck. I just wonder, there are these symbols here. What does that mean? Maybe new words. But then this one is also empty. I feel like you need some clues for this. I think so as well. Might be a bit too early. Well, but now we know there is this puzzle here as well. How can I leave this? Oh, there you go. Look at this piece of junk here. It's probably not junk. It's probably not. Side quest, is it here somewhere? No. Maybe it's starting with hello. There is no hello. Uboso. Cameloso. Hello would have been perfect. Hello. But there is no L here. Heiza. No. Or the end, goodbye. Bye is also not fitting. Yeah, I have no idea for now. Maybe we'll figure it out. What a load of gibberish. Yeah. Wish I could take it with me, though. Maybe it's marked on the map, though. Yeah, okay. The skull. We know now what the skull means. The symbols are a W or a vowel, that much is clear. Yeah, but I'll do this later on. Maybe I'm gonna understand it. Right now we're still trying to figure out how big this island is. And also, is this the middle of the forest? For the other, for this one, for this puzzle. It's looking very dense, but it's not showing me on the map, not really. Is there like a middle part? No. Why is me playing a clown? I'm not a clown, just having a red nose. I'm not a clown. Hi, Knebbers. Flo's hunt? Who's this?
Prekiktrum Hande.
Hey there, mister. You don't look like you're from around here. No. Nope. I've just arrived from a long, dangerous journey. There's a little monkey on the right side. Fascinating. So, is that a shell in your pocket? Yes. I'm a treasure hunter. You don't say. No many treasure hunters around these days now that everyone wants to be a pirate. Not me. What's this all about, Flo? Oh, I'm not Flo, I'm Scout. Flo's Hunt is a franchise. I work the crab branch. Huh. It's looking like our dog is sitting on the tree. To answer your question, Flo's Hunt is a treasure hunting game consisting of 5 rounds. Oh, mini game maybe. Each round you pay to participate and receive a map. The first round is free though, just to get you started. That's good. I like when tutorials are making the first game for free. So the map and bring back the token and you'll get a cash prize. So of all 5 rounds and you'll be crowned the Crab Island's Island Flows on champion, you'll receive a trophy and a decent chunk of cash. Are you interested? How could it not be? We should play the game actually. I'm very curious. We are playing a cute Pumuckl RPG today. Wait, Pumuckl, that was from Switzerland. Was it from Switzerland? I think so. Wasn't there an old guy who was speaking I think he was speaking Switzerdeutsch. I'm not quite sure, actually. I've never watched it. Is that a shovel in your pocket or are you just happy to see just very happy to have a shovel? I mean, oh God. play game. Let's see. I want to play. Round 1 is free to play. We'll start you out easy. Take this map and go retrieve the first token. See you soon. How's the work? I'll have that trophy in no time. Go with the flow. Crab Island. So I'm having this now. Dig up Flo's token. But I don't know how the map is actually looking like yet. I still need to figure out. Look at how big this world is. I mean, yeah, this map. And it seems like it's on the left side. Maybe we didn't find it yet. Also, look at this. Looking like a pathway you're going up. Huh. All right. Or maybe here? Da, 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 da. Huh. I'm just gonna go up first. There is no timer, right? Dig up Flo's token, or maybe it's here explained a bit better. Go with Flo Crab Island. There is a local treasure hunting competition on Crab Island called Flo's Hunts. If I retrieve all the hidden treasures, I will earn a trophy and a cash prize. All I have to do is scan the map and dig up the treasure. Easy. Easy as that. Alright, I think I found the way how to climb up the mountain. Bit of hiking. Oh, why is this sparkling here? I think Pumuckl is from Upper Bavaria. Oh, maybe. I actually never watched it. I don't know why I was thinking it's from Switzerland. Huh? Oh. Hi, is that Russell?
Wonderful.
Hi, there are sports. The name's no Sid. Way. What are you doing? Me? I'm prospecting. Looking for gold. Have you found any? I heard one's good. He was more than I'd never need. I'm being honest. I thought he was speaking Danish, dude. Just do it for the sport these days.
Danish?
Can I have some gold? Oh my god, I'm begging for gold! No. Nope. But if you're interested, I can teach you how to find some yourself. Just by digging up some materials. Yes, I'm very interested though. Sounds good. A man after my own heart. When you're prospecting for gold, you want to be looking for the source. The motherlode, us prospectors call it. Find a likely spot and take a sample. You can then clean the rocks and see if you caught anything. You might get up a couple of specks of gold or a whole bunch of them. Huh. The more specks you get, the closer you are to the motherlode. If you take a sample and there is less specks than the previous test, then you're moving away from the motherlode and need to turn course. You need a pick and pen to take samples. Best to visit bird shop down in Crab Town. Oh, I need to get the tools first. Sure, if you can beat me in an arm wrestle. Oh no, I don't think so. Let's do it. Let's do it. Where to meet your maker. Wow, what? Ready? No? Set? What do you have to do? Arm wrestle. What? I didn't even have a chance. I broke my arm now. Sorry, kiddo. Guess you'll be needing to visit the shop. Yep, I'm too. Mining advice. Like I said, when you're prospecting for gold, you want to be looking for the source. What the lotus prospectors call it. When I like this spot, take a sample. You can then clean the rocks and see if you caught anything. You might get a couple of specks of gold or a whole bunch of some. The more specks you get, the closer you are to the motherlode. Okay. Take a pick and pan to take samples. All right, bird chop. You can beat me in arm wrestle. No, maybe not. I don't think we're strong enough. See ya then. All right. So many new people. It's an empty gibbet. Is it called gibbet? I guess so. Oh, it's also here. It's brimstone. I'll need to pick if I want to collect it. Yeah, we can take that. Okay. Okay. I think you need to put some kind of pattern here. Yeah, but I don't know this one yet, so I can't do it. Interesting. Okay. There's a pattern here, but I think it's just decoration. I'm not quite sure. It's kind of the same with Bavaria, Switzerland, and Austria. Yeah, first, it sounds like this, but it's still very different. Switzerland sounds very, very different. It's very hard for me even to understand sometimes. Well, Austrian and Bavarian is you're also getting used to it though. It also sounding very similar, but some words are, they're using different kind of words. So Switzerland is different. Austria and Bavaria definitely extremely similar. Yeah, they're kind of similar, but still you can definitely hear somebody's coming from Austria or Bavaria. There is definitely a difference. Switzerland has always been a bit isolated from the rest, I feel. Yeah, I mean, they are also not part of the EU. You can definitely feel that. Definitely. I always wanted to go to Switzerland as well. Always wanted to. But never had the opportunity. Once saw this video of a guy arm wrestling in the bones and his forearm basically snapped in half. Oh my god, what? In half? And ever since I have this arm wrestling. Yeah, I also know a story about a person. He did some arm wrestling and it didn't end well, let's say this way. It didn't end in a good way, but he's doing way better now. Way, way better. And I hope he's still recovering from that. Were we here before? No, right? Oh no, we were. So is this the forest we were talking about? I don't even have access to this map anymore. I guess it's because it's because this one is not active anymore. That's why, right? Yes. Da, 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 da. Oh, look at this. There's some kind of pathway here. Chat, I found it, I think.
It's the middle. So, lost amidst the forest I be. Nine brave steps to west I flee. West is to the left. And they said I need to press the space button, and the character's counting. Nine steps. Okay. Oh, this is exciting. Then, by such turn, four north did tread. North. And then it was 12 to the east. I made my bed. To the right side. I need to dig here. Oh my god. Yes, I found something. In old time. Oh my god, we did the main quest. I better take this to Jake. Nice! Very nice. Oh, this is so satisfying to play. I found the diary. I'm so curious what he was writing down about our family. About my mom, about my granddad. Turn Jake's diary. It's right here. Let's just do it. Also, what is this here? Creepy. Are we using skulls? Where will you find one of these crusty old road signs? You'll be able to quickly return here. Ah, it's fast travel. You just pop up. Just pop open your local map and click on the little icon and you'll be back at the spot in no time. You are using the local map, right? Of course. Of course. Well, that's good to know. There is some fast travel. That's perfect. Can recommend visiting Switzerland. It's expensive, but beautiful. That sounds like Norway, actually. Yeah, that sounds like Norway. Also not part of you, but yeah. Very beautiful county, but also very expensive. Yeah, you can definitely see and feel that. I was with a school in Lausanne, and it is one of the most beautiful places I've ever been to. That sounds really nice, actually. That sounds super, super nice. I need to check out where this place is, though. I never heard of this one. I only know the big cities. I bet 1,000 here me would love that. I think so as well. I think we're very similar with that. Amazing. Thank you. It was very, very nice. It's, you know, I was a bit scared of counting steps. I thought we had to count the steps like this. 1, 2, 3. But that's not really accurate in game. It's really not accurate. Even in real life, my steps are going to be different than Desnik's steps, because Desnik's is so much taller than I am. Of course, there is a difference, but no, you're counting your steps. This is super useful. Anyway, let's talk about the diary here. Let's bring it back. I found your diary. Good job. Let's see here. Why would he bury it, though? Diary, though? Interesting. What did you find? Your mother Rosemary was definitely on the trail of your grandfather. Go on. She mentioned something about racing to stop him from committing to Bilkins Folly. Bilkins Folly. What's that? No idea. She mentioned it. I didn't write it down. So that's the title drop here. And the old Mary tank's not what it used to be. Bilkins Folly. Is there anything else? Did you write about my pop? Not in this diary. Those diaries must be in an older collection. Huh. But I've buried them somewhere else. Oh boy, why he's doing that. Where? Here, have a map. That should pinpoint its location. You're not being very helpful here, Jake. Hey! You're the one who wants to be a great treasure hunter. Well, go hunt. What is this now? MS? Oh, wait, those are the... I know it. Those are the graves. The tombstones. MS, JS, something with Sand Haven or something. Interesting. We need to... Mm-hmm. We need to count our steps as well. 7 down here, 4 like this, and 10. It's almost to the right side. Why should I just... Huh. I could just go a bit to the right side and dig up there a bit. Right? Well, that's definitely the map for this. Find Jake's second diary about our grandfather. So I think... It must be here somewhere. Where are the graves? Here, this one. Gray Sandhaven. Yeah, it's this one. So, and they want us to start here and then going like this. Whoa, those are big steps though. Or is it because I use shift? Maybe. Yeah, I think it was because... All right, we should do this then. I guess we're going to start here. Also, a problem with Switzerland is that you need to buy an additional package to have phone reception there. Really? Interesting. Also some kind of way to get money, I guess. Well, it's... Honestly, am I even using my phone to call someone? I mean, as long as you're having a Wi-Fi, you don't even need a reception, but... Well, you kind of want to have internet, though. Interesting. I didn't know this. Next year, road trip to Switzerland to eat chocolate. Oh, let's do this, dude. Let's do that. I love chocolate. Had a taxi. It's 10 euros extra on top of your normal cost to get 1 gigabyte of data in Switzerland with Vodafone. Huh. Interesting. I had no idea. Well, that's good to know. That's good to know. Yeah, I had no idea. Let's walk a bit, chat. Let's hike a bit. 7 steps down here like this. So I'm holding... No, I'm pressing the space button and I'm walking down like this now. This was probably not that accurate. I hope it doesn't need to be like this. Okay, and then 4 down, right? Like this. And then 10 up again. It should be here somewhere. I think I found it. Is it the diary? It's a crappy diary. The handwriting is illegible. We should bring it back to Jack. There it is. You must then also come have heard hot chocolate. It should be very... Dude, he's gonna eat all the chocolate in Switzerland. He's such a chocoholic. I thought I'm already bad with chocolate, but he's even worse. He's getting so happy about chocolate, it's insane. Impressive. Thank you. Super fun to play. All right, I found the other diary. But I can't read it. Right. So your grandfather was searching for something he referred to as... La Moina's gift? I haven't heard of that one. Well, apparently he caused quite the stir back in the day, tearing the island apart looking for clues. A right whirlwind of archaeological excavation. The crab settlement was still in its early days then. I don't think he spent much time with the locals. Spent most of his time up in the ruins. Huh, familiar crab hunt. So my mother was trying to stop Bilkins Folly. And my pop was searching for La Moina's gift. Or La Moina's gift. Do you know about anything about either of those? Absolutely nothing. I doubt anyone on this island would be able to tell you much either. We're not exactly a learned bunch. Well, you could try Jimly, I guess, but I wouldn't trust anything he says. Why not? Who then? For information on old pirate treasures and curses, your best bet would be speaking to Bron, a flint buddy, an old pirate sage over on Remy's lot. So many new people. It's a pirate haven. You'll love it. Though getting there might be an issue. You need a ship and a crew to help you sail out. Oh, wow. I hear there's a ship over on Felmy Island that still floats. You should go check it out. Yeah, but then I need to be... What was his name? Russell or something. Might be a bit far to swim, though. Unless you plan on taking that log out again. No. No. Definitely not. In that case, go speak to Russell in Craptown and convince him to ferry you across in that dinghy of his. So that's the only guy with a boat. Excited to see that boat. The Captain's Quest. Bilkins Folly, let's talk about this, actually. The man likes what he likes. True. Go to Verbier and eat to... Oh, in Switzerland, Toblerone. We're looking at the Toblerone. I would love to do that. I actually love Toblerone so much. It's really good chocolate. It's so good. Very delicious. That means giving newbie chocolate would never be wrong. No, you could actually never do anything wrong gifting chocolate to newbie. I think most people are getting happy when you are gifting chocolate to them. Only my grandma, she doesn't actually like chocolate. She doesn't like chocolate. I didn't know that's possible. Bilkins Folly. Are you sure you don't remember anything about Bilkins Folly or La Moina's gift? Positive. Make your way to Remy's slot and speak to a Bron Flint buddy. All right. Then we will do that. We also didn't discover everything. Oopsie. Also, we're still having this song here. Maybe we can do this together. We can listen to the song again. I mean, it's just a side quest, but maybe we can just do this on the go. Go with the flow. Go with the flow, Crab Island. No, that's not this one, right? Make active. No, that's not this one. This one. Between the grub's domain, atop a settled nest. X marks the spot. Between the southern tower and Blum's place of rest. X marks the spot. So, these are... Is this the spot or this the spot? Maybe two spots. Between the grub's domain, atop a settled nest. I will quickly mark this one. Grub's domain. That's this guy. It's this guy. I want to listen to the song again. Yes, I would like to hear it again. Sure. Wait, there's a cave here. Da, 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 da. I saw there is this part here and I didn't go inside. What's inside? Okay. Spooky. What is this? What the hell is this now? Maybe I need to find a word here. Okay. Well, there's this table with another puzzle. I don't have anything to light it, and I think we have to do the same on the right side. That looks like it goes with that letterbox. You're right about that. Let me take a screenshot of this with my phone. Where was the letterbox again? I forgot. Wasn't this on the other island? No, that was the skeleton, right? The skeleton. Maybe... No, I don't think so, because the last line was a bit different looking. I think that's another... that might be actually another puzzle, but we can try it out. Because the last line, I tried to find the way to write down goodbye or whatever. The last line was looking different, but we can try it out. I think this is a bit too long. I took a picture with my phone. There was no other interaction. We need some way to light those. Yeah. Or the keys. I don't have the right tools to open this. Okay. All right. Same here. So curious about this chest. There was also another chest on the main island. But probably we're going to be able to go back again. Near the woodsy bed. Oh, oops. Oh, I went inside again. Oopsie. Oopsie, whoopsie. But can we solve this puzzle for now? Solve this puzzle. Journal. Between the grub's domain, atop a settled nest, X marks the spot. So is this a grub's domain? I'm just guessing here right now. Don't have the right tools, as if you can't smack a lock with your... Yeah, right. Then we're also looking super old. Well, it's a puzzle game, so we need to figure out how to do that. The second part was between the southern tower and Blum's place of rest. X marks the spot. And Blum's place of rest. Wait a second. This is Blum, and this is the southern tower. Jake's diary. So it must be here. Am I just taking this too literal? The South Tower. What? Did we find something with the dog? I'm just gonna dig here a bit, but... No, I don't think so. I was wondering what the sound was. Nope. I wasted my time. A skill point? No, I don't think there was a skill point here. No. It was right here. The dog symbol was here. But it's gone now. Huh. Dum, 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 dum. No. Let me interrupt that. Between the southern tower... And Blum's rest. The southern tower. Is there a tower here somewhere? Well, that was probably a tower at some point, right? Between the... Would be here somewhere. Well, these are definitely ruins. Between the southern tower and Blum's place of rest. If that's Blum, of course. But it would be right here. Behind the house? Nah, we should probably find something by now. No. Da 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 da. Also, it's not between. Oh, never mind. I think we have to go more here. Maybe a bit more down. This is looking like it's somehow between. No, nothing. All right. Mission abort. We're going to focus on the main quest again. The captain's quest. We need to talk to a lot of people. So Russell has the only dinghy in town. I need to convince him to ferry me over. All right. Still need to discover the whole map here. Scout and sit. Also, we need to go, I think it was scout, right, and buy some tools. I don't even know if I've got enough money. No, that was the treasure hunt. Just decoration. Monkey business. Hello? What's the password? Password? Is this some sort of secret society or something? Ah, something like that. We'd be more like a guild of sorts. Well, cool. Can I join? Depends, you know the password. No, I don't. Sorry, Paul. I'm not really allowed to talk to you unless you speak the password. Guild rules. We need to talk about something, though. Do you see the spray? It's TG. Gods to put your plane. Somewhere on this island, you'll find the password hidden in plain sight. If you can figure that out, we can speak further. Huh. Right, I'll be back then, I guess. Look at those socks, by the way, and the clothing line. Super cute. I found the spray in the basement as well. TG. Huh. Is that a map? This looks like some sort of cipher. Can I see it? The guild. Oh, what the hell is this? What is this? There are holes inside. Huh, what is this standing for? I know what that's for. Okay. Big brain deeds. Need something to open this. Use the shovel. And if you're having this to shop you. Ahoy here. Welcome to Birds Nautical. Nice cities and birds. Nice place. I like to think so. Best docked store the side of the Belting Strait. That is the only store. Ask about the shop. Show me what you got. Bombs financial assistance. Ask about the shop first. Bit of small talk. So, where do you get your stock from, birds? Good question. My mother, Cynthia, runs that side of the business. She acts as my local supplier, picking up loot from the wrecks that litter the island. Mm-hmm. Your mother is Cynthia? Yep, you can find her at the lighthouse. Though, honestly, you might want to avoid her. Why? She's not one for strangers, so I probably need to prove myself. Alright, why do you have this option bombs here? Now, those bombs look interesting. Oh, because you can buy bombs. There are the casings only, I'm afraid. If you can get your hands on some brimstone, I could mix up something explosive for you, but for that I need the pickaxe. I see. For example, should do it? Where could I get brimstone from? Well, I'm no field scientist, but I'd try looking at the mountains just north of here. Yep. This is basically why we are here. Brimstone's folly. A financial assistance? How about a line of credit? What? I think you're in the wrong game. You can always try, right? Show me what you got. Reminds me of Jesh saying begging for gold in games. I would never do this. Never. And I just did it here right now. Show me what you got. So, mining tools. Climbing rope is out of stock though. Mining tools, you need $6, so that this mining set is everything. The budding prospector needs. Pick, pan, well, that's about it really. And we can buy bombs, no iron shell, telescope, lantern, buck nest.
A bug net, not a nest, a scribbled map. Bert claims this map leads to buried treasure. It's also 6 and this is 5. I don't have enough money. I actually don't have enough money. So, we need to do other things first. Probably following the main quest then. All right. Welcome back. See ya. Oopsie. Find a use for the strange page. Maybe we need to... Wait a second. I know now. I got an idea. Either it has something to do with the skeleton, and then we need to lay it over, or we need to go back to the basement, and then we need to use this overlay. No, it's not going to be here. Oh, I can't use it here. It's definitely an overlay. Ba 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 ba. Huh. Very curious. Very, very curious. Or can I do this? Wait a second. No. I can't zoom out. You need water break? Oh, thank you for reminding me. Well, my poor, I missed it. I was just begging for some money at the shop because I don't have enough money. Then I was thinking what you said with you were asking for gold in game. In RuneScape, right? Alright. This is an overlay for something. But I'm not quite sure for what. Might be actually for the stuff inside. Let me see. The cave here. Quickly checking out. It's not far away. Speaking of which, yes, which game you want to have some gold? Oh wait, it was here, right here. You see, there's the symbol here as well. TG. Can I use the overlay now? Well, I am seeing... Does it make sense? I mean, I can use the overlay here. It's the same symbol, by the way. Look at this. It's the same symbol, right? No, it's the same. Is it mirrored? There's one line here. It's kind of... It is mirrored. Oh, this is messing up. Can it rotate? I'm trying to rotate it with Q and E, but nothing is happening. Wait a second. I can also do this. Why? Wait. I got it! 4 parrots sit on Garrett, slipping in their decline. Is that the password? It's some sort of secret message. Ooh la la! Ooh la la! Who was it again that wouldn't speak to me unless I told them the password? The door. First try. Almost, yeah. Not too bad. I saw the symbol. You need to pay attention to all those little things here. Discover who the secret code was meant for. Nice. The overlay worked. It was the village down here somewhere.
Where's my doggo? You found something. Where's doggo? I lost my doggo. Oh, you're here. Let's see. What did you find? I can't even dig here. Oh, maybe here. Maybe that's good enough. Let's count for a bit. Now we got Monkey Island copy protection puzzle. I actually never played Monkey Island. Should I? Okay, it's not here. Nope. Oh, false alarm? Maybe here? Toki? Why are you calling me back? Okay, nothing here. Nothing, Tassiania. Or maybe here. But my dog is not digging here, so I guess nope. False alarm. False alarm? Huh. I mean, there are movie masters and that are apparently very good. Yeah. It's happening again. Maybe I should wait there a bit. I was here. Here? I'm not finding anything though. I'll let you know on a secret. I never played them as well. Interesting. Do you want to play them? Well, I did it here though. Maybe I got debated. But their copy protection was like this paper wheel that you have to move around for the slits to reveal the passcode. How interesting. I didn't know. Oh no, I didn't want to do oopsie. I pressed the wrong button. Maybe it's here in the corner? Around the corner? Isn't Monkey Island also about pirates actually? Like the game gives you a prompt. What's the passcode for position X, Y, and Z? Huh. Yeah, maybe I should play that game at some point. Since it's a classic. Once I'm gonna go away, it's gonna react again, right? Toko? Okay, I'm leaving. I'm gonna reveal the password now. Toko, come! Dude, I knew it. I knew it. But I'm here now. And I'm curious. Four parrots sit on a garret, sleeping in decline. Aha, nicely done. The name is Framilla Spiticus. And call me Fram. Nice to meet you, Fram. The name is Percival Bilkins. Excellent. Can I take it that you're interested in joining the guild? What kind of guild is that? I think it's safe to say I am. Is it? Right? In order to enter into the guild, recruits must demonstrate certain skills. Uh-oh. I am skillless. Didn't I already do that with a password? Look, you're halfway there. You've proven you're nimble of wit, but you must also prove you've a deft hand. Here, take these. What are these? It's a set of lockpicks. These are training ones. They only work on simple locks. If you want to join the guild, you have to prove it by picking the locks next door and retrieving the item in the chest. Alice Aaron, one, thank you so much for the follow. Welcome here. Huh. There is a door right next to us, actually. Do that and you'll be one of us. One of us. Roger that. Break into the locked out this one. You know, I love to lockpick in Skyrim. That was super fun. I love to do that. Let's see. Maybe this is also going to be a mini game. And yes, I think I want to play them someday. We actually should do this then. It's a classic. I only heard good stuff about Yeah, Monkey Island. Pretty sure I already own them. I don't think I am owning them. Wait, they're not called Monkey Island, right? Wait, my brain is... No, it is called Monkey Island, right? I'm not the biggest fan of the pirate thing. No, me neither. Me neither. But I wanted to give it a try. I'm not a huge fan of point and click in general speaking. But every now and then I can do it. I can do that. I guess this is also a bit of point and click. It's Secret of Monkey. Yeah, I think so. Wasn't it called Not Deponia, right? It's Secret of Monkey. Yeah, it's something like that. let me open this door. Let's see. How does it work? Lockpicking difficulty. Novice. Ah, okay. This reminds me of potion... what was this potion game? Q&E. So, we have 4 parts. I actually like these puzzles a lot. Very classic one. So this is a very long one. This could never fit here. This is the longest we can get. The question is... No, man, there's no question. There's only one way to go. This is this one. Then, what about this corner here? Or is it just important that we are fitting all these parts here? Maybe that's the point. But I can't imagine. I like this typing sound. Now it needs to fit perfect, of course. Ta-da! Oh, little confetti! Tetris stream. Well, we're inside the hut now. There's a chest! Oh la la. What was the game? It was the alchemy game. Where I was healing people. I was a little witch. Little witch in the woods? I'm always forgetting the names. Wait, we need to lockpick again. Let's use the same method, actually. So, this long one could fit. Oh, well, that's going to be interesting. So, we could... Maybe there are different solutions, actually. Oopsie. No, I didn't want to do that. Well, this is the way to go. Ta-da! Potion... I think it was Potion Craft, right? Played so many of those. Yeah, but Potion Craft was actually really good. I love that game. We were the little witch in the woods. There are so many little witch games, I guess. But there was also pixel game. Very cute. And we were having an hospital. People were sick and we were trying to help them. And there was also some kind of puzzle game to craft the potions. I guess it was Potion Craft. What's inside? Exciting. What's that? What is this? Statue. A funny looking item. What can I do with this? I should show this to Frem. Well, we need to prove it. We need to prove that we are worthy for this guild. Potion Permit. Maybe it was I think it was Potion Permit. Potion Craft was literally the game where you were having this map and you were having customers, right? Yeah, I think so. All right, Fran. Look what I found. Wow, you got in. You sound surprised. Yeah, I guess I am. Thanks for your help, though. What? Hey! I'm being used? Wait, I'm a thief. Yeah. Sorry, I couldn't for the life of me get that lock up. Okay, dude. Thought my bosses were going to kill me. I'm a thief. So you're not a guild recruiter? Oh yeah, a member can recruit someone. Yeah, this kind will make you mark you as a member of the guild. Maybe can you getting some discount or something? Quest complete the guild. Nice. If you show that at red doors like this one, you'll be able to chat to other members and potentially upgrade your lockpicking set. Huh. Interesting. Handy. Well, oh, and for future reference, don't go around trusting other members willy-nilly. We may be brothers, but you know that whole thing about honor and thieves. Well, okay, we did one side quest. How do you hang up those socks to dry? How do you get them back down without falling? I have no idea, but they're looking very cute. Once I came here along, I also saw the socks, and yeah, I was also thinking about how cute they're looking and how are you actually getting them. We didn't even talk to this person here. Hi. Shh, you'll scare away the fish. Okay then. So we're not going to talk? He's really into fishing. If only there was some way to get her attention. Chocolate? Okay, I guess I don't know the item yet. What about this guy? Excuse me? Oh. Russell? Is that Russell? Oh, that's the boat! I was hoping to talk about your boat. Not talking, nothing. It's going. Can I help? Fix that, then talking. He sounds very drunk. What? Russell had grog, banana, yellow flower, blue mushroom, jail herbs. Banana? There is one banana, the one of the monkey has it. Okay. So, okay, he wants some grog again, even though he's already drunk. Huh. Give me the full release of Little Witch in the Woods. That would be great, right? But it's going to be in early access for a while, I think. Unfortunately. Seems highly impractical. That clothing line? No. I agree. Banana nana. Yellow flower, blue mushroom. Well. Russell had something. Collect Russell's ingredients. There's one banana on top of the roof. Hello, monkey?
Guy,
hey there, little fella. Nice banana, by the way. Oh, what? We're just getting a banana just like that? Without doing anything? Good monkey. Now, where did that duck go? I got a banana. Bananas done. Yellow flower, blue mushroom, jail herbs. Jail herbs. Let me actually go back to the cave. There were also locks, right? I wonder if I can lockpick them as well. Where's my doggo? My doggo is still here and I don't know what it's barking at. Da 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 da. This is not a jail, right? I mean, some kind of.
Ironing.
I don't have anything to light. Huh. Maybe we can do it. Okay. Oh. Alright. Same stuff. Maybe we should start with the biggest part. So. Where could be the biggest part? Definitely not here. Because there would be one left. Also not like this. But maybe we can fill out this corner. Maybe we can do this. And I think I got enough. Ta-da! All right, and I think we have to do this again. Alrighty. So I think it's pretty clear that we have to place this over here. Everything else is just not reaching here, so we have to do it this way. But everything is just long. Not like that. But like this. We got it. There you go. What's inside this chest now? Money? Do we have actually money? So I can buy the pickaxe? Well, that's disappointing. Why? It's just an old bag of stinky herbs. Oh, maybe, wait a sec. We need those herbs, right? These must be the herbs that Russell wanted. Yeah, that's good then. That's actually pretty good. They must make a tasty stew for him to go to all this trouble hiding them. Jail herbs. Let's see. Yeah. Then let's open this door. I wonder what this is here. Probably we can get... maybe we can go down the basement? Alright. This looks a bit more complicated. Well, where to start? Maybe we should start with this corner. Then, Interesting. I'm always trying to rotate with R and then I'm wondering why is it not working. Lockpicking difficulty tougher. So it needs to fit perfectly? How is it possible then? We don't have enough. We don't have enough? I actually didn't even look out for the other difficulties. Guess that's not the point. I'm pretty sure this goes here though. Do we need more rocks? And I just... No. Aren't we missing something here? You might need better lockpicks. I think so as well. Because otherwise we can't solve that one. Yeah, maybe we have to come back later. Well, we did a bit of progress though. Let's see. What are we still missing? Grog, yellow flower, and blue mushroom. I thought maybe this is some flower. Nothing. On the other side, we still didn't discover the whole island. Maybe we should do that. I was only here so far. I still need to go over here and over there. So much to discover. But yeah, I think we need better lockpicks. Alright. I'm still surprised we got the banana just like that. There's a diary here. Or, wait, you're sniffing. You found something. Coming. That's a one confident stove you got there, right? I love the animation in this game. It's a hook for catching whales. Oh no. Poor things, yeah. Those are actually harpoons. Horrible, it's so cruel. But most important, you got this one. Fishy Adventures Volume 3 by Gail Tootenboot. In this series, I'll be covering different fishing destinations across the Treasure Isles and what type of catch the resourceful fisherman or woman might hope to find. Baits. Before setting out, all fisher folk
and know the importance of bringing the correct bait with them. While the cheapest rod can still pull a prize, if that stinky piece of tow cord on the end of your hook sends the fish swimming in the opposite direction, then what's the point? Crab Island. Crab Island hosts some noticeable prized fish that the keen angler will want to check. With a loosely populated island that boasts no fishing industry of note, anglers will find docile fishing among these waters. The spotted catfish. This snoopy button feeder prefers calm and sheltered waters. As such, fisher folk should target the base around Crab Island. Unlike its freshwater peers, the spotted catfish is not too fussy with bait, though it does seem to show preference for worms. Porcupine fish. The tropical porcupine fish that habits the waters around Crab Island will puff itself up as a defense mechanism. As such, okay, it's called porcupine fish here. Caution should be practiced when handling with the spiky prey. It has been spotted in the water near the lighthouse at company with a prickly human that guards that section of coast. Perhaps due to its barbed nature, porcupine fish will bite at a bare hook. And the greasy lungfish. While not the tastiest dish out there, any angler hoping to complete their shopping list of tropical catches will need to add this slippery eel-like creature to their list. While I've yet to see one in the waters of Crab Island, the locals assure me that they can be spotted on Lonely Palm Island, apparently attracted to the ruins there. Just like the person who decides to eat one of these creatures, the lungfish is not picky about its meal. Alright, lots of information here. Fish, I love fish. Fish is so tasty. Super, super tasty. Well, we got some information about some fishies here. Well, this palm tree is looking a bit odd, but maybe that's just a bug. Okay. It's looking actually a bit odd. Where are we now? We are still going down here. And there's a farm? Seems like it's a farm. Hello. Oh, somebody's here. And my dog is also sniffing something. Yep, coming. What is it? A jam jar. I can taste the berry grease. Yoink. Keep up over fish. I like both actually. Wait, I can't jump over. How can we talk to this guy? Probably just by doing this here. There's another book. A series of random entries recorded over an undisclosed period of time. Cabbage and lamb. That's all Lord Fillmore says to me these days. Well, he can have his fill of cabbages, but Davy Jones' locker will dry up before I let him take a bite from one of my prized beauties. Captain dropped by this evening again, asked how my brewing experiments were shaping up. That fellow doesn't know the meaning of the word patience. Everything's now. With all we've been through, he'd have learned a bit of it by now. Still no luck with the search without some simple map tools. I don't even think it'll be possible to find again. Cynthia's still sulking over the whole thing. Captain reckons I should best avoid her. I don't know why. It's not like I was the one responsible for the flooding. Oh, there's a sheep or a lamb. Hello there, young man. Hi. You're a funny-looking pirate. I'm not a pirate, though. I guess I was once. These days I'm a simple farmer attending to my bleating crew. A bit smarter than the average pirate, mind you. Previous life. There's also a timeline before you ended up on this island. Someday I will invite you to Turkey, then you can eat Turkish fish and bread in Istanbul. I can imagine you would. Oh my god, that sounds amazing. That sounds really good. That sounds like kebab just with fish. That sounds really nice. Yeah, let's do this. Like, let's just do it. Previous life. Said he used to be a pirate. Sure was. One of the best.
Sail with Barnabas down there in the capsized crab. That is, until we wrecked on Crab Island one night during a particularly nasty storm. Well, do you miss it? Miss what? The thrill of adventure? The freedom of the sea? The adrenaline of battle? I think he's missing it a bit. A cool grog in your hand through the day, a warm hammock at night? No! Oh no! I don't miss that at all. Why don't you go back then? I don't feel like I can leave Crab Island for reasons. Plus, I'm too old. The sea is a harsh master. You could join my crew. You're right, you're too old. What the hell? You're never too old. What the hell? No. I need a crew. You could join me. No. Like I said, the island and me are now linked. Besides, do you even have a ship yet? I'm working on it. Well, no. Join my crew. I'm just gonna ask again. I'm putting a crew together. I want you to be part of it. Do you have a boat? I think we have to go back. I have Russell Singy. And the finding is, it is too. So I don't think I'll be giving up my farm just to go sailing off with you in it. So it's the same answer, basically. I was thinking maybe it will change after we got the boat. Their flights, they stumbled for 50. What? We book early enough, only I would avoid the winter, also summer. So something in between. Damn. That's crazy to me. Flying is so much cheaper than just taking the train. It's insane to me. Yeah, that's crazy. It should never be like this. Never. But yeah, reality is looking a bit different. Yeah. Wait. We're digging. What is it? A dented teapot. Now I'm thirsty. Yoink. Oh, this is looking nice. Actually, we didn't check this out for a long time now. I've just got an achievement. 8 pieces of junk. So, interesting items. Those are quest items. Oh, we're almost halfway through. I would be probably a bit faster off stream, but I'm getting distracted, which is fine. But look at all this stuff here. You can discover lots of things. This is super, super nice. I didn't get any fantastic fish, though. I'm gonna get one fish at least. I don't know how you're able to get them. Probably with a fishing rod. That's might be a good idea. All right. So, we figured out there is... Oh, wait. Was here, right? We figured out there is a farmer living here. And, now we are also able to see the farm on the map. What's here at the end of the world? Let's see. I'm saying this because it's here at the bottom. And we are having this guy here. And also my doggo is sniffing something. Right next to him. Can I just do it here? Just use the Orient Express. Watch out for murder, though. Maybe one day. I'm thinking of ahead in time, the whole level in the chain. The chain levels were super nice. I found a necklace. A necklace. Is that a necklace? It's hard to see. Okay. I'll take it. Who's this? Well, look at that. If you're not the Bilkins, I don't know who is. Oh, he recognized me. I am. Wait, how did you know? You even sound like a Bilkins. Let me guess, Percival Bilkins. Do you know me? You're good. How? You should be asking who. I was well acquainted with Winston Bilkins, your grandfather. Huh. You know Numapa? I'm looking for him and your mother Rosemary? I'd figure it as much.
Also here on Vera.
It's been years since I saw either of them, and I'm afraid. Honestly, and I hope you don't take this the wrong way, but I think your grandfather might be... It's okay. Dead. What? Why would you say that? Your grandfather was obsessed with finding some mysterious artifact. Believing that it existed somewhere in the local cluster of islands, of which Crab Island is but one. Winston would come and go as he tried to uncover this prize, traveling between the islands. Until one trip, he never returned. He once told me that if he's gone for longer than a year, something's befallen him. I see. And my mother? Don't know, if I'm being honest, we had a fight and she wouldn't talk to me. Huh. About what? Why? Your grandfather had certain wishes if anyone ever came looking for him. I was prepared to honor those wishes no matter who came calling. Your mother was in such a rush that she lost her temper. Call me a few names. Let me guess, she called you Dunknocker? Yep, among other things. Got a mean tongue on her when she's angry? Anyway, accused me of hindering her search and never spoke to me again. What was my grandfather's last wish? For his documents to be scattered across the island of this region, if he'd been missing for more than a year. Took me ages to hide those. I'm not going to just give away his secrets because someone calls me a rank flop face. Whatever this means. Oh, that's a bad one. She must have been really mad. He also wanted me to give this to anyone who came looking for him. A chessboard? Yes, mind the damage. Your mother hit me on the head with it. What? She completely lost her temper. What's so significant about this? Oh, it's a very special chessboard. I designed it personally with your grandfather's instructions in mind. It holds the map to Winston's final puzzle. Great. Let's open it. Oh, if it was that easy. See, I designed it so that it would only release one piece of Winston's map at a time. And only if you do something for me. Of course. I'm in archaeologist, Percy. I spend my days uncovering and documenting historical artifacts. Items other people might call trash or... junk. For each historical artifact you uncover, the chessboard will spit out a piece of the map. There are 64 pieces in total. Oh, damn, so much. Interesting. 64? That's ridiculous. A little. But Winston was very clear that I wasn't to give up his secrets to just anyone. That it must be earned. Think of it as a special challenge, reserved only for the truly dedicated. I've already found a bit, but how the heck am I meant to find 64 pieces of junk? By time. Pieces of historical significance. Anyway, take your time with it. There's no rush. I'm sure that pooch of yours... will be a great help in this task, especially once he starts getting the knack for sniffing out the kids. True. I was about to say, where's my dog? But it's behind me. So, one piece of... one artifact equals one piece of map. I guess that makes sense. Excellent. I can't wait to see what you dig up. Yeah, good luck to me, I guess.
All right. Side quests. The junk trail, right? I met Jim Lee, one of Winston's acquaintances, on Crab Island. Turns out he's fond of old junk and asked me to bring him any pieces I find on my travels. For each artifact I bring him, he'll give me a clue piece in exchange. That'll help me track down Winston's diary. Apparently it was my grandfather's wish to have it broken up and hidden across the islands in this region if he went missing for more than 1 year. Jim Lee also gave me a chessboard to keep track all of the clues. And I think this is the chessboard. Junk count 9. Examine. How is this working? Okay, interesting. I have no idea what to do. Do we even have enough parts? There are some symbols here, but I'm not quite sure if that's gonna help us. The music is nice. You're woken up so often because they check your tickets and IDs. Then you sit in a cabin with the strangers. With strangers, and you're on the road longer than with a car. Oh, wait. We're talking about the train, right? You don't want to go to Turkey with the Chain as children. Once went to Turkey with the Chain. That was pure horror. You remember this one? It must have been such a long trip. I would love to try out a sleeper train. Me too. There is actually one from Berlin to Stockholm. And it's also driving over Denmark. It's like, I don't know, 20 hours or something. No, it's actually even longer. What am I talking about? It's actually super long. I would also love to try it out. But we don't have many trains in Germany. I think it's getting more. And I think there are a couple of them are going to Switzerland even. They are trying to offer this a bit more. There was a chant where it was not even existing. Yeah, they reopened some night trains. They did. But the one from Berlin to Stockholm is actually not an offer by Deutsche Bahn. It's another company. I think it's a Swedish company, actually. After mostly closing them in the 90s. Yeah, it's a shame. It's a shame. But I think... they figured out people want to travel like this. I mean, we're also having Flixtrains now, but the Flixtrains don't have sleeping cabins. I also saw, I think, was it Austria or Switzerland? I think they all ordered new trains and they're looking so nice. They're having super nice cabins inside as well. Actually, it's like a little small hotel room. It's super nice. The German part is probably the shortest one way. Probably from Berlin to Hamburg, I think. But it's taking a couple of hours. It's not that fast like an ICE. No, it's definitely slower. But yeah, I would like to try it out at some point. I was also never in Sweden, actually. I wanted to go there as well at some point. Next time. Maybe next year. Yeah, I don't know how to solve this puzzle here. I don't have any hints, I guess. There's something in the background. Maybe I don't have the right map parts. Yeah. I guess not. I can't even connect those roads here. No roads. Something with the hills. I don't even know what this is. And I got this. Never mind. But we just need to find more clues. Maybe that's going to helpful. Next time we can drive to Sweden. Yeah, we can do that. We can do that. Let's discover a bit more of the map then. I also figured out all these areas. I think once you went over here, it's not having a pattern anymore. So let's just walk a bit here. And we're also getting a fast travel point here. Uh-huh. But we don't want to go back. Bum, 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 bum. Discover a bit more in real life. True. Yeah, true. Anything suspicious here? No, right?
bum, 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 bum. Lots of shipwrecks. Holy moly. Oh?
Let's dig together.
I might... Oh, never mind. It's here. What is this? A small bell of a ship. Sailors would have used this to announce their position in foggy weather. It still crashed here. Yoink. Looks like a cowbell. 48 to 52 hours in the chain only leaves from us. Oh, damn, that's very, very long. Oh, no wonder you're remembering this then. I'm sorry, mate. Bad experience. That's actually very long. Wait, Zamnik, you mentioned this one, right? There was a chain. That's the Orient Express, right? A chain starting somewhere. Was it in Russia? And then going over. Oh, God. China and. Oh, God, I forgot. Also, I kind of want to do this as well. But I think those are very old trains. Oh no, the Orient Express doesn't exist anymore. Really? Damn. Then it was another train I was thinking of. No need. No, I guess so. I guess so. Yeah, I mean you're having planes nowadays. Countries I do not want to go. Not currently. Not currently. Hopefully it will change in the future. Hopefully. Maybe we should go to the middle part. It's very foggy here. Oh? What's this? Some kind of symbols. What can I do with that? It's a kind of sus looking, but I don't have any interaction here. Interesting. Maybe just decoration in this case. I think China is a super beautiful country. I think so as well. I think so as well. I'm a bit lost in the woods. It's hard to maneuver here. Oh, I think I found a way. So did we discover something in between? No. The capsized crab. Oh? Sniff, sniff. I'm here, buddy. Didn't you need a blue shroom? Yes. Did you see a blue shroom? A rusty hammer? Wait, did you see a shroom? Then I will head back again. We still need a blue shroom. Yoink. In the bog? Okay, give me a second. Wow. I actually forgot about the blue shroom. We need blue mushroom, yellow flower, and grog. Maybe you can get the alcohol here somewhere. So, A blue shroom. Oh, wait. Where am I? I need to head back down here. No, you were sniffing something here, right? Sniff back. Was it here? I think I need to do it over here. Gotcha. What's that? Did you find? Not gonna find many brains around here for it. What's that? Huh. So where's the blue mushroom now? You're right! It's here! Wow! Oh no, I didn't want to do this. I can just grab it like this. Dude, it's two blue mushroom. Cool. I bet that's the Russell, the one Russell wanted. Very nice. Actually, very, very nice. Yeah, I didn't see this one. Let's see if we can find the rest. So what was this on the left side? Ba 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 ba. Oh? Is that Grok? There is a bit of Grok in the bottom of this. Ew! I'm sure it's just what Russell needs. Just a few drops. Ew. That means we're actually only missing one ingredient. Yellow flower. That sounds like sand, though. But I just can't offer a sand, right? The capsized crab, close to late. Huh. Yellow sand. I found it. It's a spoon. What a forking waste. How's it looking like? It's a huge mountain coming. Yellow flower. Sounds could be also corn. Looking so empty here. I feel like I shouldn't be here. Huh? Where's that dog running off to now? What is this place? Oh! What? Oh, hi there, lads. I think I found Josh. Hi. I see you met my dog. I met Chapooch. Such a sweet dog. Oh wait. Are you okay? Yep. That cool guy's mohawk is too cool to be. Sorry, lad. Ah, never mind. Sorry. That's okay. His name is Drayton. Or maybe he's also missing his dog. Comes from good stock, eh? Sure does. He belongs to my mother, but I brought him over with me from our home in Ireland. Oh, your mom was happy for you to take him? Well, actually, we're looking for her. Rosemary Bilkins. I don't suppose you've met her. Sorry, lad. I've not been on this highland a long time. I plan to settle down and build a house here, away from it all, but... I guess this place isn't for me after all. We've got a fine sailing companion here there, son. Then the name's Newt. And Percy. Tell me... Newt, how did you call him like that? Spent much of my life with dogs. They're a pirate's best friend, you know? Aw. Not a bird? Really? Only problem is they keep falling off your shoulder. You see? That's why you're having a bird. Birds are the best. Tell me, lad, what tricks does your sea dog know? Drayton? Sometimes he finds junk in the ground.
Anything else? Well, no. I don't think he's the chick's type of dog. Nonsense, lads. Any dog can be trained. All it takes is an owner wanting to spend the care and time bonding with his mate. You seem like you know a lot about this. I listen. If you ever lose sight of your pup form your lips, like so and whistle. That's really good to know because sometimes I'm not finding him anymore. The pooch is able to, he'll come back to you. Wow, thanks. I'll have to remember that next time he runs off after a seagull. Don't chase the birds. Are there other tricks you can teach me? I could teach you, but most tricks take time to learn and perfect, and you'll need to strengthen the bond between yourself and the pup. How do I do that? Just interacting with the pup will build the bonds between you both. Take time and every now and then you give the pup a pet or to heap praise on him every day. Over time, your pup will learn to read you better. If you really want to strengthen the bonds quicker, though, keep your eye out for treats and toys. There's nothing a pup loves more than to play with his owner and to get little rewards. True. Once you've built up the bond enough, you'll be able to teach the pup a new skill. By keeping a record in that journal of yours, you'll be able to keep track of when he's ready. So we're just not talking about this. It's actually a thing in the game. Bet the dog. I hope we can do it now. And when he's ready to learn a new skill, what do I do? Here, pass me your journal. I'll show ya. I think we're getting a new entry now. Yep, there it is. And I think there's even going to be one more. There's a little gap there. So, there's a skill tree now. Falling behind. Sit, stay. Tug of war, lapdog, doggy paddle, leaping pupper, here boy, bloodhound, pushy boy, bring super sniffer, howling dog, trustful, fast learner, and super sniffer too. So, I guess that's the next one. Sit and stay. Oh, look at this. Ask Drayton to stay put while you wander off and have all the fun. Use it for solving certain puzzles or just impressing your friends. Fall behind, okay. Tug of war. While it might... What is this? Oh. But it might look like a game to us. Drayton takes tug of war very seriously. What is this bar here? Oh, this is the different kind of commands we can give them. Who doesn't want to be carried around now and then? Lapdog? Oh no, how sweet is this? I'm carrying the dog. I love these animations. They're insanely cute. It's so well made. It's and I know it's very small, but you can see the gif here. We're carrying the dog around. Oh, that's so far. Oh, that's very heartwarming. Doggy paddle. Like that wet dog smell. With this skill, Drayton will overcome his fear of water and swim after Percy. Oh, it's not swimming. He's avoiding water. Oh, interesting. I didn't know that. There is a question mark. A mysterious skill revealed at level 20. Oh, okay. Leaping pupper. Test Drayton's trust in you by commanding him to jump across dangerous gaps. Huh. Well, a lot of things to do. Sit and stay for now. Each time the bond bar fills up, our duo will gain a skill point to spend in the Drayton skills menu. These points can be used to unlock new abilities that Drayton can learn. He's already learned the whistle command thanks to nudes. By unlocking different skills, not only does the amount of interactions between Percy and Drayton increase, but they can also use these new skills to access areas that were previously blocked off. Holding Q in game will bring up the command menu, allowing Percy to issue commands to Drayton. This is the one I saw in the tutorial. Drayton will follow you around to the ends of the earth if needed.
Coming with me? Nice, good boy. So. Oh?
Iron in, will and a dog.
Wait, flowers! Rosa wanted some yellow flowers, not flower. Oh, wow. Oh, yellow flower! It's a... I was thinking about corn or sand. No, it's actually a flower. Okay, wow. I got fooled there. We meet again. How did you get over here so fast? I didn't even solve the other puzzle. Us undead have a little trick we can use. It's called the Undead Highway. Any known grave acts as an entry point to allow instant travel to other graves. That sounds, scary and disgusting. Sounds handy. Can I use the Undead Highway? I don't think so. I think we need to be dead for that. Sure, we can. Oh, really? You gotta die first? No, thank you. Actually, I think I'll stick to more traditional modes of transportation. Yeah. Suit yourself. I know a song about the spot. Did you want to hear about it? Or do you want to hear it? Yes? Maybe it's another puzzle. The smith's son was a feisty one who roamed the town all night. Upon his list, his first visit, Miss L to her delight. Then down the road, Myrtle Toad, before a job in at a McShawn's. Hot Stan Jane, just down the lane, marks the stroke of dawn. Da-da-da-da! Well, it's definitely a new quest here. Definitely. We're having a lot of side quests now. That was Brimstone Folly. Kaboom. Collect 3 deposits of the sulfur. We need to go back to the mountain, but for that we need the pickaxe. That's the other... this one. The Morning Mausoleum. I went to Carlos again on Crab Island. He had another song to share with me. We need to do this as well. But for now, I think I am quickly heading back to... What was his name? Russell, right? And there was a quick travel here somewhere. Oh, there's also a book here. It's been 6 months since I've buried my best friend and I still think about her every day. I've hardly bothered with the house. What's the point, really? I'm stuck in a quagmire of apathy of which I see no end. Some evenings I can swear I hear her barking in the distance and I startle awake, forgetful for a moment and rigid with excitement only to realize the smashing of waves against the rocks below have fooled me again. Is it a curse of the gods that we be gifted with such a companionship only to have it taken from us in such short order? Perhaps it's a sign that no god exists at all, or that they are just so uncaring. What can stir me from these doldrums? No, oops, I was pressing the wrong button. Oh, sniffing boy. Let's do it.
Marsh is calling.
It's
me and a goose.
An old linen sack.
Dig ear, did you run?
Boy. Well, good for a collection though, and also for the chessboard, right? Ta-da! Yes, it's for a chessboard, of course. Wasn't there a quick travel? A fast travel? Oh no, it's more on the right side. Da-da-da-da-da. Can't believe I got fooled by the red... By the yellow flower. No fooling me. Alright, almost discovered everything. I guess I should have gone... Yeah, I should have gone here as well, but I didn't. Alright, fast travel over here. And going down back to this little town or village. Or point of interest. All right, buddy. I've got all your materials now. I got the ingredients on your list. I even added some hair of the dog as a bonus. Give. Oh god. Oh yeah, come on. What?
The suit my carried.
Excuse me. I was hoping you could take me to Foamy Island. Ah, fine. Take me to Foamy Island. Sir, I'd like to hire your services, please. I hope we are going to be able to go back, though, because we still need to do a lot of side quests here. Oh, you just... Okay. Oh, this is this small island. What? That's super small. It's actually insanely small. Travel to Foamy Island. Yes, let's do that. Drunk drive. Yeah. I mean, there are not going to be any other people on the water. Oh, no, he's leaving us. Oh, no. Me and Drayton will scout out ahead. It might be best if you stay with the boat, Russell, in case we need to get out of here in a hurry. Russell is not here. What? Russell? Russell? Okay. Poke around Foamy Island. But I think this is actually a good way to stop here now. I guess we are going to figure out if we're going to be able to go back to the Crab Island again. And also to this island. What was it called again? The Palm Island. Oh, never mind. Okay. I'm not quite sure if you are... I hope it's not too linear because I still have the other quests. I hope we are going to be able to go back now. Well, I guess we're going to figure out. For now, I would like to say thank you so much for trying out. One second. This very, very cute game called Bilkins Folly with me. I had lots of fun. I really like the puzzles here. I really like them. And I think they might actually going to get even harder later on. But right now it's having the right amount. But if you want to play it, if you want to have it a bit more, if you want to have them a bit more spicier, I guess, you can also play in hard mode. But we played it for, played in normal mode today. What am I thinking of this game? It's very fun to play. It's full of little puzzles. I like the story so far. It's kind of intriguing. I want to see what's going to happen more. And it seems like it's also one of those bigger games, actually. It was very fun to play. And I need to figure out what other tools are existing. And I also need to figure out if we're going to be able to... if we're able to go back to the other islands. It's a neat puzzle game. It's nice to find treasures. You're having different kind of islands. I'm not quite sure if it's... I just need to figure out the island. It's kind of bothering me now. A bit. But I think the puzzles can be trickier at some point. I mean, I still didn't solve some of them. And I think that's just going to be the beginning. Very fun game. I love the graphics. I love the animations with the dog. It's very, very cute. Very well made. It seems also there is also some kind of hint system if you're a bit stuck. But I didn't use it that much. I think the NPCs were able to talk a bit more about what you have to do. But right now, we didn't do bad. I think we actually did good. So I'm very happy about the results. And I'm also very happy that I could showcase this game to you guys. Thank you so much for trying out Bilkins Folly today. Thank you. I really appreciate it.